performing Baisden After Dark with the stylish comedy of Lil Rel. You've been watching Baisden After Dark, setting it down. You've seen this comedian on the Bad Boys of Comedy and TV1's own Who's Got Jokes. Make some noise for Lil Rel. What's going on, y'all? Make some noise. Give me some energy, everybody in here.
Yeah, buddy, I'm in the building. Hey, I'm having a good time today, real talk. This has been a great show. They up here talking about shacking up. I can't shack up with nobody. I still live at home. My mom and them, you know what I'm saying? I can barely have company. That's real talk. Shacking up, man, that's not where it's at. My parents been together for 25 years, you know what I'm saying? They moved in when they got married. But when you live with somebody that long, man, they get along like not really. You know what I'm saying? Because my mother and father are both crazy. Like my father, I got a 70s father. See, a lot of y'all don't even know what a 70s father is. Every time my daddy talk, he point and he bend down. This is my daddy. And he used old 70 terms like, happy birthday, turkey. He's like, what? What's going on, jab turkey? And my mother, she smokes cigarettes. Now, I don't know if anybody ever grew up with the mom with the, like, with the daddy voice. You know what I'm saying? That's very confusing. Growing up as a little boy, and your mama sound like your daddy. That's confusing. I just come in the house like, how you doing, mama? How you doing? That's how she cough. Cough with her mouth closed. And the messed up thing, I got a deal with my parents. I stay there, but like the deal is messed up. I don't pay no rent. I pay all the rest of the bills. That is a horrible deal when you get messed up, ridiculously priced cable bills. Like, my mother and father keep ordering movies, but they're not even ordering new movies. They order a bunch of old movies. You go buy somewhere. I'm looking at the cable bill. It's like $500. I'm like, who keep ordering Sparkle? You know what I'm saying? Like, movie is old. Like, I order Sparkle Turkey. That's my daddy. And my father still think he tough. See, let me tell you something. My father came from that Black Panther era. That's his real talk. I got a real man as a daddy. You know what I'm saying? He's a grown man. He stand up for his community, but he don't know when to stop. He don't understand. There's real thugs out here. They don't give a damn about you bending down, pointing at people. You know what I'm saying? That don't mean nothing to them. It's a true story. I'm not. That's what really happened. I came to the house the other day, right? This is before I came out here to do this show. I walked through the gate. It was a bunch of people in our gate because we got this hood rat that stay downstairs. Even if she had the job. There's always a bunch of dudes in our gate. So I come upstairs and tell my daddy, like, man, there's a bunch of dudes in our gate. What dudes in the gate? I'm like, look out the window. He said, you talking about them suckers out there? I'm going to teach them a lesson. I'm like, what? So I'm telling him, like, look, daddy, now, I'm going to keep it real with you. I don't know if you watch American Gangster. Okay, these dudes are thugs. Okay, they in the gang. Okay, you don't need to be coming out. I ain't scared of nobody no gang. Why? Because I used to be a dragon. Dragon? What's that? Matter of fact, he had the jacket. Nancy, get the dragon jacket. Which one, the leather or the blue chain? Which one you want, So this dude put on this little dragon jacket. Now, you ever see females with a little baby fat jackets? That's how my daddy's dragon jacket looked. It was like a little vest, had the sleeves cut off, it was shingling all at the shoulders. Had a dragon on the back of it, had his real name on the front, Milton. There wasn't even no gang name. This had his government name, Milton, right? Now this dude putting on cologne to fight. That's how I knew my father. Like, Nancy, what Old Spice said? Put it on me. To teach these suckers a lesson. That's how he walked outside. Like a production coming. So he get outside, man. A bunch of these dudes looking at my daddy crazy because he got on a vest with no shirt on, his chest hair showing. So everybody like, man, what is this old dude on? Hey, player, what you want? What am I on? I'm about to take care of some business, unless you start giving me some bread around here. They're like, what, you hungry? No, I want some money. You know what I'm saying? Like, so look, just my father standing there. There's a bunch of these dudes. They trying to be nice. I'm like, look here, old man. Now, we don't want to hurt you and everything. You coming out here all by yourself and all calls and everything like that, Joe. You need to just go ahead, take your old self back in the house, man. We don't want to beat you up. What you mean beat me up? You think I'm by myself? They're like, you is by yourself. You're like, no, Jimmy on his way. Now, Jimmy. There's the only other living dragon left. Okay? This dude pull up with a van with curtains on it, you know what I'm saying? You can see him with his little dragon jacket on through the window. And he ain't even playing no fight, so he pulling up with Caribbean Young Queen playing like this will scare somebody.
He in a van putting on a spike glove trying to show these cats. They got guns. He got a glove doing this. Like, let's go scare them.
Make a long story short, both of them almost got killed. But when Jimmy got out the van, this is what messed everything up. See, y'all got to understand something about Jimmy. This is my uncle, you know what I'm saying? Jimmy don't hear that good. He kind of old. Like, you ever see somebody so old they got to take off their glasses just to hear you? And he going crazy. Like, he gets mad if you don't understand what's going on. He be looking at you. What's going on? I see your lips moving, but I don't hear nothing. Hold on. What? Why he say that? And the thing I love about my father, like I say, he's a real man. Like, nowadays, men ain't men. That's why I got man laws, man. If you hang out with me, I got these laws you got to abide by. You cannot be my friend unless you abide by these man laws. Like, man law number one, if we hang out and you drove and you dropped me off, you're not supposed to see me get in safely. That's real talk. You drop me off, homie, pull off. I'm at the door nervous because you still sitting there. Like, hey, player, go home, man. Hey, go, I'm good. I'm in the gate. Go home, man. Matter of fact, don't even tell me you made it home. Don't call my house and I'm asleep. I'm in the bed asleep. I pick on the phone like, hello, I made it. Who is this? It's Bobby. I made it, man. You don't care? No, I don't care. Go to bed, man. You must be a Scorpio. That ain't none of your business either, player. Go to bed. That's a man law, too. No signage. Even with text messaging, men should spell whole words. Don't ever give me a one-letter text answer, man. I don't trust you. I text you, come outside. You're like, K. Where the O at, player? And what are the parentheses of these two dots? You smiling at me? K. I'm not even comfortable with a man putting on lotion in front of me. Y'all would have laughed. That makes me nervous. Somebody in front of me, yeah, you know, like I was saying, you know, man, I got too much. Get some. And I'll give you one last clue. The way a man claps. Every man, when you clap your hands to stay in the C. The C. You see this? C. When you clap, yeah, I'm a man. I'm a grown man. C. Now, if you're on the other team, and sometimes y'all see this at church on Sundays, I'm getting real. A grown man singing soprano, you see him. He claps totally opposite than that. And you see him in the choir, so I'm going to show you. Be like, a one, a two, a three. He's able. Bow. You see this curve? Look at this. If your head curves like this, you need to kill yourself right now. Because you are going to hell, and I ain't coming with you. Hey, y'all, I'm Lil Real. That's my time. Peace out, y'all. Last laugh in the building.
The scene. Show some love for Lil Rel. We come back on a special time with our special musical guest, Chaser. You're watching Baisden After Dark.